Welcome to AlzheimerVideoNews.com, an ongoing critical look at the most important news in Alzheimer research. In a recent issue of EMBO Reports, published by the European Molecular Biology Organization, Howard Wolinsky writes about the uphill struggle and arduous process of advancing scientific knowledge into becoming accepted wisdom. In Path to Acceptance, Wolinsky writes that the super detective Sherlock Holmes, invented by British author Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, famously held that when you have eliminated the impossible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth. One might assume that this purely logical principle applies equally well to new scientific ideas, given that scientists, like Holmes, seek to uncover the truth. Ideally, a new hypothesis that helps to explain previously unexplainable observations should therefore replace previous theories. Wolinsky goes on to say, not every scientist has faced the amount of hostility and ridicule that Charles Darwin did when he proposed his grand theory of evolution in 1859. In explaining how life on Earth evolved, and implying that humans were not formed in the image of the Creator, but rather were descended from apes, Darwin invoked the ire of the scientific community and the church. Wolinsky further posits that scientists do not always follow a path of pure logic, quoting the very cynical yet believable observation by the great German physicist Max Planck, who lived from 1858 to 1947. A new scientific truth does not triumph by convincing its opponents and making them see the light, but rather because its opponents eventually die, and a new generation grows up that is familiar with it. Thus, Wolinsky concludes that the history of science is replete with theories that only become accepted by the scientific community after a long and protracted uphill battle. He cites the example of Stanley Prusiner, who met a similar fate when he proposed that proteins could be infectious agents. His prion theory, which won him the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1997, needed many years before it was accepted. And that of the Australian physician Barry Marshall, who won some of the most prestigious scientific prizes, including the Robert Koch and the Lasker Prizes, before the clinical community grudgingly accepted that he was right. For his insight, Marshall was eventually awarded the Nobel Prize together with Robin Warren in 2005. It is not only the hypotheses that shatter well-established knowledge and theories that are ridiculed, dismissed, or rejected. Even a simple insight, for example, that the H. pylori bacterium, rather than the physiological problems, causes stomach ulcers, is not always quickly accepted. Finally, Howard Wolinsky sums up that it is not only the reluctance of established research fields and communities that slow down the uptake of revolutionary hypotheses, but also a general reluctance to explore new ideas and support those who do so. To find links to the entire EMBO Reports article, Paths to Acceptance, by Howard Wolinsky, as well as other information on scientific breakthroughs relating to Alzheimer's disease, please visit AlzheimerVideoNews.com. AlzheimerVideoNews.com is a production of the Institute for Neurological Research, INR, a private medical group, Inc., in Los Angeles, the developer of a patented new approach to Alzheimer's disease treatment, paraspinal etanercept. Please bookmark our pages and visit us often for the latest developments in Alzheimer's research.